Welcome. This video is part of the DAX Made Easy series, and today we're diving into all of the count functions. You can see them here. There's a lot. There's count X, there's count, there's count rows, count blank, count distinct, count no blank. There's a lot. We're gonna fully equip you how to understand all of these quickly and easily, going through a real world example using Power BI Desktop. So let's dive into it. Okay, so here we are. I'm gonna talk about every count and then show an example, but first let's just look at the data set we're gonna be using. So within this Power BI file, which is available on GitHub so you can follow along, there's gonna be an order line and then a price and a quantity for every order, as well as some orders received discounts and some did not. So I'm gonna be focusing on the discount row for this video. There's other tutorials and different DAX functions that's gonna use the same data set, but just note we're looking at the discount as an example here today, as well as the total rows. So let's just start from the beginning here, and we're gonna look at the classic count rows. So what count rows does is it's gonna return every row in a specific table for any grouping you have selected. So in this case, I have furniture and as the category, and then it shows the order line, and then there's a total. So let's start a new calculation to see how this looks. It's gonna be called count. I'll go count rows. This is gonna equal count rows. And what this requests or asks for is a table name. In this case, sales. We're gonna count all the rows of the sales table. Return this. We'll look at this here so you can see it. And if I add it, all right, it's adding the number of rows. So this is important. Then you can come through and I'm gonna put a comma in just to make things work. So this total data set has 9,994 rows, 2,121 are showing up here. Great. And you can see that some orders have discounts and some do not. So let's keep going through this idea of counting. And so now we'll count blank. And if you ever need to understand how many of a rows are missing a value, count blank's perfect for that. We're gonna use it on the distinct column. So I'm going to start by doing count blank discount equals count blank, and then it's gonna ask for the column you want. In this case, I want sales discount. And what's great, now I'll add this. You can see that it's counting the blank. So this is blank one, this is blank one. This is not, it's not counting it. Come up here, add the comma. So there's 4,798 total blanks. Okay, good. So that's working. And now let's go through and we'll do some of the counts. So again, this works for any value that's in there that are non-blank, numbers, dates, strings. So let's add a new measure. And we'll look at count. And we're gonna do count discount equals count. And then we're gonna pick the same sales discount table. So what this is doing, add the comma, is when we're counting something, we're saying how many of them are there? So we're counting everything that's not blank. So in this case, this number is different because we're counting discount. So this is not counting this blank blank, but right here there is a value. So now we're getting a count of one, and it goes through that process for every single group, every single row. So there's 5,196 total counts of total orders that have a discount. Now let's understand the difference between count and count X. So what count X is gonna do, it's gonna enable you to put an expression and then count up the results of that expression. There's lots of ways to do that. Count X is an efficient way to essentially count the number of rows that contain a non-blank value that evaluates at over an entire table. So let's see what that looks like. For an example, let's say we wanna count every discount. How many discounts are there that's over 20 cents? All right, well, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use count X for that. Because it's gonna iterate an expression over a table, getting a lot of values and returning them to us. So I'm gonna do count This will be called Count X Discount Greater Than 0.2. Horrible title, but it's gonna work for this demo. So I'm gonna select Count X, oops, wrong one. Count X over sales. And just to first show how to make this thing function a little bit, I'm just gonna put in the value here. This is not gonna return what I want, but it's gonna be the start. So this is currently counting the exact same thing as before, is all the discounts. All I can do, well, what I can do now is add the filter context to have this iterate and apply it to every single row. So when I have this function here, now I can come up to this and insert filter. I'm gonna filter this table based on the expression that discount is greater than 0.2. Hit enter. And now you can see it's slightly changed. So this row right here is 20 cents. It's not greater than, so it's not getting a count. So it's working. Count X iterates over every single row so you can apply calculations and expressions within it and get the result that then will roll up to the aggregate level. So if we minimize these things, we know that there's a total of 1,393 discounts that are over 20 cents. Here are their groupings. You can go in and see the details. That's how that works. Well, the final two will be discount or distinct count and distinct count no blank. So distinct count returns the count of unique or distinct values in a data set. So you can think of it as if there's 1,000 rows and we want to know the distinct count of sales and every sale was $1, well, then that's going to be a distinct value of one. So just one unique value. So let's see what that looks like by saying, well, let's do the distinct count. How many different types of discounts are offered? How many different discounts? So we can do that by saying new measure. We'll do distinct count discount equals distinct count of discount. We'll see quite a few things here. What is this doing? Every row has a one. Why is that? Because every value in here is unique. It's counting everything, even empties. To say that empty is a unique value. But what happens is at the aggregate level, it does that across the entire data set. So for every single row in this entire table, there's almost 10,000 rows. There are 12 unique discount values. You can always confirm that if you're curious by, say, going back to the table, looking at the discount field, and you can even see here's the 12 different discounts that are available. They're spread across all the different rows. But blank is not a discount. It's counting blank. And the reason why we know that is because we can look at the raw data and see, well, it's saying that this is a discount. That's actually not. So that's an example for where you need to use distinct count no blank, which is very similar to what we just did. It's gonna have a slight variation, but it's not gonna count the blanks. So distinct count no blank discount equals big old long word, and we're gonna do discount, just like that. It's gonna be almost the same, but slightly different now, because what this is gonna do, it's gonna say, all right, well, the blank values, we're not gonna count anymore. And we are gonna count then everything else. So there's actually 11 unique values, excluding no blanks. These are all the core counts you need and the count functions to understand to use across any data set to add and enhance that DAX experience. So please subscribe. We have lots more videos coming on Power BI and DAX both. If you ever have any questions, leave them in the comments. I'll always reply. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.